Welcome to War Mode.
The debate the next 3 weeks, I'm told, gay marriage, a flag amendment, and God only knows what else. I can't believe the American people can't see through this. We already have a law. Marriage is between a man and a woman, and states must respect that.
Every show can be our last now. Every broadcast. We're up to the end game now.
Why was I born in this world? I keep on saying to myself, this is not a world for human beings like us.
Coach, I'm gay.
You don't know homo town where we from, bro.
Mom, I'm transgender.
They're going to take us out, but you've got to escape the Millennium Falcon back to base and come back and take out the Death Star. But I might have to go throw up first.
Good morning, single women. I am single. I am looking for hugs. Not sex, but hugs.
The men who do so. End of quote. Repeat the line.
What the fuck is going on here?
Of Putin's kleptocracy. Kleptocracy. The guys who are the kleptocracy.
Wipe your ass and get out of here.
I feel like a deer in the headlights of love.
My shit is on play. I don't pause.
You ask for it, you're going to get one. Spiritually, I'm like a flamethrower right now. I mean, it starts with a war growl. It starts with getting fired up, staring at yourself in the mirror and showing some teeth.
People keep asking me how old I am. 69. You want one? Message me.
Give you guys ride bikes.
More. He's back. That kid on the TV just called me a dickhead again.
Excuse me. I think my testosterone's going up. This happens every time I start working out a lot again.
These motherfuckers, they talking to y'all, and then we gotta try to understand. They shouldn't be in this world with us. Somewhere there's a loophole.
What would I have done?
Yeah.
I would have done a legitimate investigation to find out what exactly happened on 9/11. How did they know who did this so quickly like they did Lee Harvey Oswald?
Who's going to investigate the investigators? Who's going to investigate the prosecutors? Who's going to hold them accountable? Who's going to hold us public officials accountable? And that's all we're trying to do here, in addition to trying to find the truth.
Do you honestly and truly in your heart believe that Sandy Hook actually happened? Yes or no?
No.
All right, number two.
And I'm here to tell you, 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms.
Because you're in jail.
Secretary Clinton.
It's only just begun.
Here we are, back again. That was a night. The Ball of Confusion was just a very good song to an intro, too.
Yeah, nice collab.
What's the dude's YouTube?
Oh, Magnum Extended Mixes.
Yeah, Extended Mixes are fucking key for that shit. Did you hear the David Hogg shit?
No, what's
going on? He fucking wigged, bro. They were doing like some gun safety thing.
He's such a fucking attention whore.
Dude, watch this. I'll get the clip right now. Hold on. Yeah, so he was sitting in on some like gun control thing they're trying to pass, and then he pulled a bait out. Listen to this.
Reiterating the points of mass shooters in your manifesto. The shooter at my high school, anti-Semitic, anti-black, and racist. The shooter in El Paso described it as an invasion. Guess what? Those guns are coming from the United States of America. They aren't coming from Mexico. They are not coming from Mexico. You are reiterating the points of a mass shooter, sir. Sir, you are perpetuating violence. You need to realize it's not enough. A Democrat or Republican, stop these things now.
Yeah, I wonder what his fucking endgame is. He's on a med one. He wants to be something, obviously.
That was like mannerisms, everything, and like, dude, people have.
You're saying he's mimicking Beto.
He's mimicking Beto, and people have said that, and people have said, not me, that he was the shooter at Sandy Hook. If you look at the picture side by side, he looks like that. As people say that, I've heard that. I saw it.
Heard that.
I saw the picture. And went.
Made you go, huh?
I just don't understand, because that dude's probably around the same age I was when I found out about like Four Loko.
Yeah.
So I'm not going into Congress. I'm going into fucking a store using Matt's ID to get Four Loko and having the jitters all night long.
Yeah, I think that he's on some weird kick, dude.
Yeah, I get
it. You know, he wants to be on, get clips, go viral, be political.
That's weird.
I mean, doesn't like Charlie Kirk do that shit real young?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, it's like a thing to do.
It is weird. I always, whenever I see these people, I just think of that.
He's from Parkland, right?
Parkland shooting, yeah, dude. Yeah. Act like you don't remember that.
Hey, man.
You can never just forget.
Jog my memory. I'm a little fried.
Yeah, he's from Parkland. He's just a weird fucker all around. He like supposed crisis actor, but he's just doing weird fucking shit and trying to get, like, that was a girl was filming him. He's like, check this. I'm going to do this.
Is this because of a current shooting? Like the last shooting?
No, it's just because they're trying to ban guns. And the guns they're trying to ban are commonly used weapons. And like Nadler and all those dudes are like, yeah, they shouldn't be commonly used. It's like, bro, but they are. So just chill the fuck out. Like, you're not going to stop any of this stuff.
Oh, yeah. But shootings around me are insane right now.
They'll never. It's so fucking
bad. There's so many fucking shootings every night. Every night there's another one.
And dude, I was watching stuff where people are saying a lot of it's over chicks.
I bet, yeah.
A lot of these dudes are.
Dude,
fucking,
that's the most fucking pissed you can get.
I agree, but like these, imagine if like at 19, 20 years old, now looking back at 19, 20, you had that sniz there. Would you kill for it right now?
Not right now, but then yes.
But dude, someone's got to sit these boys down.
They say criminal activity falls off at 27.
I would believe that.
Yeah.
I mean,
they say like it's like after 27, everyone kind of figures out like, oh, that's retarded.
And you'll get hurt.
Yeah.
No, like
up until then, though, you're a monster.
Yeah, I guess, like, didn't they say, like, kids that age are sociopaths, like, 17?
Well, kids, younger than that, yeah.
Yeah, I don't understand it at all. Like, this dude, if I felt that seriously about this, I wouldn't say, yo, videotape me so I can put this on the internet. Because that was retarded. You're just shouting into the fucking abyss of a courtroom of a bunch of people who don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
And now it'll be on the internet for a week.
Well, he's on the good team. You know, he's against anti-Semitism, anti-racism, he's pro whatever. I don't know. You know what I'm trying to say.
Pro gun control, yeah.
He's out there just saying, look at me. I'm on the team. Sign me up.
Yeah, and like, dude, he's sitting there, and he made like a point to say that like it's not Mexicans that are bringing in like guns and stuff.
That's what that's about? Okay.
Part of it.
Yeah, I was getting confused.
But it's like, hey, dude, like a lot of the shit, what the fuck? It was one of the cartels. I was watching an El Chapo thing.
Most weapons come from the United States. They're like hand-me-downs.
Yeah, but like I think it may have been Sinaloa. They started in L.A. And then they're just running back and forth moving weapons. Like, that's a huge problem. That's as big. It's bigger than fucking mass shootings.
Yeah.
A bunch of Mexis just died in a fucking tractor trailer, dude. It probably happens every fucking day. You should probably try to secure that instead of like a school shooting that may or may not happen every now and then. But
I heard some dude like there was a shooting in a mall. And there was a hero, a Pierce Marin.
Yeah, Pierce put him down.
Yeah.
What's the guy's name from Thermal List? Reese. Reese took him the fuck out.
Reese took him down.
That must suck. If you think you're actually going to like pop off and then immediately you're shot.
You got a lot of shots off.
Did he really?
Yeah.
That's fucking crazy. I think most of it just has to do with the fucking psych meds. People are medicated to a different level. Like the one dude I know, he drives. And, like, dude, he's just on, like, a normal low-dose psych med. He goes, I don't give a fuck about anything.
Yeah, that's probably not the best psych med.
That's what I'm saying.
That's not doing much healing, I don't think.
Yeah, I think if you're pissed off and you don't give a fuck about anything, you'll probably do some you'll probably act on all things you're thinking about.
Yeah, I don't know. Tom was telling me they're going to legalize MDMA therapy for people. So it's going to be, like, you're only going to go for a few sessions. It's not going to be, like, a lifetime of therapy. People like sign up for therapy and game over. It's like you're doing this for the rest of your life now.
Isn't that like a lot of fucking money?
Oh yeah, bro. And that I would imagine there's like people lobbying against some of these psych meds or some of these psychedelics coming out, because when they first came out, all the psychologists were like, oh yeah, this is all we need.
Really?
And then Big Pharma was like, no, man, you can't use this. we got to get him on this shit.
That would make complete sense. Like, if they, like, shit from the earth heals you, all that stuff.
There's so many therapists will go out of business if they legalize MDMA therapy. This is what they do for the troops. Those troops see some fucking shit, and they kill people, and they come back, and they're like, I'm a monster, and I can't adjust to this life here.
Yeah.
And then they start going to the MDMA therapy, and the MDMA fucking shuts off all the bad vibes, and you sit there, and you're like, oh, I'm not a piece of shit. It's like, no, dude, you're actually a hero.
Yeah. I don't know how those dudes come back from that much shit, and then you just start fucking trying to, like, go grocery shopping. I'd be losing it constantly. Like, I just have a pretty easy fucking life, and I lose it constantly. To be that fucking ready to go.
Yeah, like that wound tight.
Yeah. That would be fucking sick if they just started giving everyone MDMA. Especially, like, I think they're going to need something because this shit is not working out, and you can see it in a lot of fucking chicks.
Well, I would just say you're going to get better results in the SSRIs.
Yeah.
You know, people are on that for a lifetime. They're worried. There's an anxiety where you're like, what if something happens and I can't get my meds?
Dude.
You know?
Yeah, that's a hard life to fucking live.
I don't know. If you like sit and do like talk therapy with MDMA, then you're only done. You're done in like 10 sessions or whatever. You're like, oh yeah, I figured that out. And you keep it pushing.
Yeah, I mean.
Go in for a checkup every once in a while instead of like every fucking week.
Yeah, that's why I get sad when I think about all the cancer stuff that probably have a
cure
for. And then it's like, how are you going to keep the lights on these huge buildings? They just made a pen, bro.
Yep.
It's a tough
There's
one.
Big time lobbies from Big Pharma that push for slowing down like certain treatments.
Yeah, I would. Yeah. If there's that much money tied up in it, dude, easily I think they would just chill shit the fuck out or just buy it out and then shelf it.
Yeah, they've gotten a lot better at it. I think if there are certain cancers that you got in the 90s that you would have survived today. They do push it along, but
just nice and easy. Yeah. So they can get something else.
They go nice and slow.
Yeah, that I was watching there's a bunch of data.
They don't like rush emergency use for it. It kind of is like a problem. But they're like, nah, we're cool on that.
They don't want to skip
human trials, none of that. Yeah.
Yeah, I was watching a bunch of shit on Bandot video and Ike came out. And I've never, like, dude, I fancy myself a fucking COVID denier. That motherfucker
sticks to his guns, doesn't he?
It's crazy, dude. Yeah. And I'm all for it.
Yeah.
He came out about the lab leak theory, and he goes, that was fake news for fake news.
The lab leak theory is fake news.
So he said, like, they do this on fucking everything. And this makes complete sense. Because, like, shit.
Red herrings.
Yeah. So, like, some people believe that it just fucking came from a bat. Yeah. And then for everyone that didn't believe, they're like, oh, something real fucked up happened. It came from a lab in China that was in UNC.
Right.
And Ike's just saying both of it's malarkey. It's just the mind virus.
Wow. Big statement.
It makes fucking sense.
Yeah, sure.
Like, think about how.
Hey, I'm not a virologist.
Like, you got us on it, no problem. You got the Weinstein dude who was like, actually, it came from a lab. I figured it out. They're trying to fucking hide it. If they send you on this many wild goose chases, it's the same shit we talked about a few weeks ago where it's just like, dude, you're just on a million wild goose chases that kind of sound true, but they just aren't true.
Yeah. They do the gain-of-function research, though.
Yeah, that shit's fucking wicked.
Yeah, they do have labs.
I never understood, like, what the purpose of that was.
It's just to make money. It's a way that they can they have an excuse to do their work.
Speaking of fucking making money, that NASA telescope, dude, the Webb one?
Yeah.
They took a poll after putting those pictures out, and they were like, what do you think, guys? You think this is worth, like, whatever it was, 10 million, 10 billion? They're like, everyone across the globe is just like, of course. This makes complete sense. Keep on giving them all their fucking money.
And you think that Guardians of the Galaxy has a better
portrayal of space?
Portrayal of space.
You know. I think it's like the movies.
Yeah, you're like, CGI could have done it.
Well, it's all fucking bullshit CGI, which is just infuriating, and I don't want to piss off any of the scientists because we already got them up in a fucking tizzy.
Well, you can see it from amateur astronomers.
Yes.
It's pretty cool.
Well, I'm saying this deep space business, I don't believe a fucking thing that's happening in NASA, and they're getting all the same.
You're pro Space Force, though.
I don't know.
We're going to need them.
We're going to need something.
Russia's going to try to take out our satellites.
Dude, that's what I'm saying. Like, Jones is near tears all week long because, like, he's been saying the one world government shit forever, and they came out and they're trying to push a bill that gives the president dictatorial powers. So if some shit happens, and this is where Ike comes back in, he's saying there may be fucking aliens, but the shit they're pulling right now with all these UFO sightings, he's like, that's just our technology. Because obviously we're going to have some crazy ass shit now.
I don't know, man. I'm not a scientist. I actually think sometimes we go backwards.
What do you mean?
Like, dude, a lot of people are retarded. People get dumber like Idiocracy.
Good point.
You know? Yeah. I don't know.
Ike was saying that they're going to fucking, like, this bill is going through.
Yeah.
They're going to release some sort of fucking UFO attack, be it real aliens, be it government. And they have to get a whole entire council of all the countries together and all the continents. Say, we got to stick together and we got to do this. And then it's just going to usher, this is Ike saying this, it's going to usher in the fucking digital dollar, and it's going to just be a global fucking government, and you're going to be on UBI because shit's going to be so fucked.
Because of aliens.
That's what he thinks might happen. Just because, like, out of nowhere, they've been pushing this shit like crazy.
I feel you. I'm listening.
Yeah. I have a fucking eerie feeling that they're going to start doing some weird shit with fucking aliens and UFOs. Because at this point, they kind of ran out of everything else.
Well, they got World War III cooking.
Do they actually?
Yeah, they're pushing it pretty hard. We just went to China with a destroyer in the sea.
Yeah, this is nonsense, dude.
They're asking to get hit, is what it is.
Like, China's asking
to get hit? No, the U.S. is, like, asking to get hit.
They're trying to pull one of those.
Yeah.
That is going to be fucking AIDS if that shit happens.
Yeah, it's going to be the end of everything. That's, you mean nuclear weapons.
Yeah, that's going to suck. These all these things make more sense.
Or they'll do like a blackout of the internet through taking out our satellites.
They're already doing it. They're doing blackouts literally fucking everywhere. And this is back from the, what was that, Cyber Polygon?
Yeah.
This is this is last year, maybe 2 years ago. It was fucking famines and blackouts, and they're literally doing this shit right now.
Yeah.
It's fucking insane.
I know.
And, dude, I just went to get tape. It was $12 for blue tape.
That's inflation, bro.
It's fucked.
Everything's going to start costing a fortune.
Yeah, I don't know how the fuck people are going to survive with this shit.
There's no end in sight of the lower gas prices.
Yeah, I wish there may be, though, bro.
What do you think?
Definitely not. I wouldn't vote for him.
But you're going to get back in there, dude. You're going to get back in that booth.
I swear to God.
I know you are.
I'm such a clown. I could never make myself look like more of a clown than when I fucking went and voted.
Yeah.
I fucking went in there. I put X's instead of filling in the bubbles. I'm a fucking retard. I'm never doing it again. It's just a waste of my fucking time. I'd rather just chill and have fun with my family and friends.
Exactly.
That's happy making time. This shit fucking blows.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if there's aliens. Don't know if there's gonna be World War III. But this is the shit that they're pushing out.
I feel like it's like
that, and the future lockdowns.
Yeah, that's,
and they're talking about masks again. For some, like, the masks have been debunked, and on CNN they're talking about masks
viciously. And my boys are sitting there talking about how the vaccine didn't work, and now everyone's just like, like, it's actually hurting people. And if they try to pull this, I don't know how they would do it again, though.
What do you mean? They gotta get boosted, and they gotta take medicine.
Oh, you think they like got it? Like,
they got them already. Yeah, they gotta get they gotta keep getting shit from them, like antivirals, and get boosted.
That's gonna suck so much, dude.
Yeah, this is negative stuff.
Yeah, any stuff on the positive side?
I don't know. I mean, I've just been existing, just working.
Yeah, I completely turned.
Trying to turn the ship around. I slept.
That's,
I mean, you're just getting me back off of, like, I just started sleeping again for the first time in like 2 months. So you're gonna have to, like, give me a minute, get myself together.
I mean, this is good stuff.
I was like, oh, dude, I'm gonna go to South Carolina. When I come back, I'm gonna have a new life. I came back, literally same exact life, didn't do shit.
But you slept for 12 hours.
I slept for 12 hours, so maybe that's the start of it, and I'll get back to normal.
Dude, when I don't fucking,
I haven't felt like myself in fucking months, dude. I've been crazy.
What's myself, though?
I don't even remember anymore, man. I'm just existing.
Right, that'll
this
happen.
This is like a fucking great reset.
Dude, I swear.
I'm just here.
The lack of sleep fucking cripples you.
Yeah, like, lack of sleep's fucking brutal, dude. And I've been on it for the last couple months.
Yeah, I have no idea how the fuck you do
from 3 in the morning to like 6 at night. And I know fucking new dads and all that shit. They go through that shit. But dude, they also have yeah. Try that in a fucking self-made prison.
Yeah, you just have to turn back on Netflix and watch a fucking TV show. Anytime I've done that, my life, like everything I start doing makes no fucking sense. My thoughts make no fucking sense and I just hurt.
Yeah. I've been on like autopilot because of this. And it all culminated because I fucking put on Terminal List and I watched it straight through.
You cooked that straight through.
I cooked that straight through. Then I was up again another night after that, and then I went out and got something to eat for the first time, like eating out at a restaurant.
You sat?
I sat, ate fries, ate a sandwich, and then when I got home at like 8 o'clock, I fell asleep. And I woke up at like 11 and I thought it was like 6 in the morning. And then I slept for the rest of the night. And I'm just here, dude. And I'm sorry if I'm not funny enough. And I'm sorry if I don't know what you want to talk about. But I'm doing my fucking best right now.
Good, dude. Honestly, guy like me.
Trying to tweak your intro. I was having a fun time doing that, you know?
Intro is fun.
Whatever.
That's good stuff.
Yeah, it's good stuff. Good times. Having fun.
If people want to, just chuck up a Y. If you just want this to be an hour-long intro, we could easily do an hour-long intro a week. You don't have to hear from us ever fucking again. It'll just be a good time for an hour. You can turn it off, be confused, and that's it.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I'm trying.
The feeling of sitting back down, good.
It was good. I forgot that like when you go to restaurants, there's like hot waitresses and shit like that. I forgot about that. I forgot about like the outside world.
Yeah, I mean, you really have.
I've just been plugged in, programming at my house, and I just go to yoga to work out and try to get ready to like actually work out. Like yoga's kind of like fake. You know what I mean?
If you're trying to build yourself,
If you're trying to get big,
I honest to God, dude, I think if it's yoga and working out. Muscle mass is eminent. People say TRT is fucking bad for you. I would say
you want me to do that so bad,
dude. I'm just saying, like, currently I don't want to fuck with my shit.
You're gonna do it though, the way that you're easily, talking. Yeah, you're just gonna be on
in
it.
My 40s or something. Yeah, I you're feel just like
gonna,
shit.
The second that you feel like this is diminishing, you're gonna go on it.
I dude, from
shot
the,
in the ass.
I don't know. I'm hopefully that's like I'm not about needles. Never could do heroin if you fucking paid me. If you could make some sort of thing that made sense, like there's no bad side effects in like 10 fucking years. LASIK eye surgery, TRT, all that shit.
You're going to wait for Big Pharma to catch up to what you need.
Or if there's a super chill guy that like hates Big Pharma and goes, guys, I figured it out.
Oh, he's got his own?
We got our own type of thing. But I swear to God, dude, if you did that shit, and maybe the Patreon goes up high enough where we can chuck you down to Austin, Texas and get stem cells.
I doubt it.
That would be epic. Especially if your body started regenerating, that's like giving you 15 extra years.
I've just been beat up for the last couple of years. Like five, I just beat the fuck out of myself. All it is. I was fine before. I don't think it's like a testosterone thing.
But I'm saying,
I mean, like, obviously my testosterone has gone lower.
When you start working out though, it'll fucking shoot up. I think like that shit. Some sort of thing like that would be very good if they figured it out and it wasn't.
To me,
like,
it's a blessing because I was real horny. Like, you're fake horny.
Oh, come on.
But I was like legitimately horny.
Scale 1 to 10.
I mean, I don't even know if they'd have numbers for this. You are like fake horny. You're like, oh, dude, look at her. I'm real horny. Nah, like, in my heart, in my chest, in my soul.
Guy like me, it's just when I'm driving through Center City, I'm not.
It's criminal. You should lose your CDL.
They're gonna get me.
Eyes on the road.
They're gonna get me. When I'm dropping
dude,
a dumpster.
Two lane blacktop, white line. That's all you need to know.
Dude, I'm just dropping.
So you're telling me you're putting people in danger with a load on your back? Pause.
Dude. On the fucking road, confusion happens when people see me. They're like, nah, dude, you're not gonna be able to get in there. Like, oh, calm down. Don't worry. So like, if I'm going down the street,
autopilot.
It's autopilot. I'm listening to Spanish music. It's not even fucking English. And I'm just going, dude. If I see a hot mamacita, dude, I get wooded. It just comes with the fucking territory. I have no idea how dudes work in Center City all day long.
Like, construction?
Just in general. Yeah. I don't know how, like, dudes work in offices.
Oh, in
with
offices
chicks.
With girls? I couldn't imagine. The crushes that I would get. Like, if I got to know a girl.
Yeah, multiple. I mean, dude,
I'm in a cage, bro.
That's what I'm saying. I went to all boys' school. I went to all boys' school. Then I went to fucking college. I never talked to one girl in one fucking class. The only thing I can remember about being in college classes is constantly sniffling and then looking back on like, Jesus Christ, I was like sniffing up all my loogies and shit. Probably no one would talk to me.
Yeah, that's weird. I don't know. I think all boys' school is a little weird, but.
Yeah, you know.
At least I have the memory of interacting with chicks.
I know. Yeah. I'm like, every now and then they let me out of fucking solitaire. We had one class that had chicks in it first thing in the morning and then they went back. But, I mean, I think for dudes, like grown men, I'm just happy that I'm doing what I'm doing, hanging out with my bros, working and shit like that. I could not imagine having a fucking wife, going to the office, having a crush at the office. Like, you're not getting shit done.
That's like a thing people do.
What do you mean?
They have their office husbands.
Dude, I'd fucking...
Girls do this shit.
I'd Oklahoma City the place.
You were talking about timelines. We don't talk about timelines. That's fucking Timeline City. When shit turns south, that's Timeline City, bro.
I mean, not to sound like a fucking sexist, but it just shouldn't happen. Like, there should be girls and boys.
You could be totally happily married. I mean, this has happened in The Office.
What?
Have you ever seen The Office?
No, I never watched it.
Hit television series everyone loves?
I only watched a British one.
No,
I'm just kidding. Didn't watch either.
Like, the beginning of The Office is this chick, Pam, who's a little cutie. She's a little secretary. She's like she's a receptionist.
Yeah.
And she's going out with a dude in the loading docks. And then fucking Jim is like a goofy little office guy. And he like comes in the office and he's Mr. Steal Your Girl. And he starts flirting with the receptionist. But she's engaged to be married to this dude in the loading docks. And that's the show.
Guy like me and you.
The show is this fucking funny guy comes in. And
did do the Benghazi movie.
And just starts, it's cool.
It's a character he played.
Yeah, it's a psyop, but he starts, he comes in and he starts, you know, making her day every day. And then that's her office husband. And then they end up together. And she ditches the other dude. That's the show. It's a satanic show.
But like,
it's demonic and chicks love it.
Obviously.
Like if you go on online, if you go online dating, it's nothing but The Office.
Gym for Pam.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think. People like that show. There's some
Parks and Rec. Everybody loves Parks and Rec.
I don't understand how there's dudes though at the, like, if I'm at the office, I'm on the competitor and I'm trying to like plug away an Excel sheet and if someone walks by, it's immediate. Like you're not bird dogging chicks the whole time. You're like dead set. Like
you would get fired. I would imagine today. You can't look like, dude, I don't know what it's like, but from what I've heard,
this is like people talking about what's going on Mars.
Almost impossible to work in an office with the rules and like the social cues.
Yeah, I mean my buddies I know, like I haven't even put the girl situation in there.
Yeah.
Just let alone with like the they, them, she, him shit.
I was listening to some fucking thing, some podcast, I can't remember anything that has happened to me in the last couple of months, but they were talking about how dudes are like, people used to meet at work.
Yeah.
But they don't do it anymore because the guys can't ask the girls out because it's sexual harassment. So they're afraid of catching a case. So like they just have a crush.
Yeah.
And they just never do it. Never go through with it.
I've been strictly
unrequited love.
I've been strictly in jail mode with women in the workplace.
In jail mode?
Yes. Like in all boys Catholic school, if she's a 4, she's a 7.
Right, okay. I got you.
Girl's gonna back up at the dump.
So misogynist, you rate girls with numbers.
Obviously. Girl's going to back up at the dump. I'll get out of my truck and open the can. Can't help it. I'll simp immediately. Dude.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I wouldn't get a fucking thing done at work the whole time. I'd be simping.
Yeah.
And these dudes somehow just like fucking go out.
So
like,
my mom was trying to get me to watch this fucking show, the CIA show. Oh, it's a dumb show. Don't watch it. It's fucking called The Old Man. And Jeff
Bridges. Oh, dude, I only watched 2 episodes.
Yeah, Jeff Bridges is there and like, I'm like, oh, this is right up my alley. This will be cool.
Yeah.
And then, like, in the middle of the fucking show, he just starts simping to this chick for no reason where he should have killed her. And, like, he simps to the max, to the point where I have to shut the show off.
Dude,
I don't care
it?
What happens.
I did that with Squid Game.
I started that, and then Terminal List came out, or I found out about Terminal List, and I was
Terminal
like,
List makes fucking
later,
sense, bro.
Later, guys.
Terminal List makes fucking sense.
Later, this is my shit. Make another one.
Yeah.
Keep making these, please.
I have one episode left. Physically don't understand how there's another episode, but that's okay.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, like, it's a treacherous environment to try to do, like, to try to get anything fucking done. You need a corner office with the fucking door.
Oh, yeah. Like blinders?
Something. That's my whole fucking life. I'm just trying to work hard enough so my wife doesn't have to have a work husband.
I mean, it's got to be on your mind.
The fuck home.
It's got to be on your mind if your chick's coming to the office, or if your girl is working at a bar, or if, and pretty much anywhere.
Fucking
if
hospital, dude.
They're pretty much out in the world.
Yes.
You gotta be worried. Land. You gotta be worried, man.
Yeah, I hear
some young dude. There's another movie that's out now. It's another like Get Her Groove Back type movie.
Get Her Groove Back?
Yeah, do you remember Stella Got Her Groove Back?
Didn't see it.
Yeah. Well, that was like a phenomenon when that came out. It was like older chicks getting younger dudes, yeah, getting their groove back.
Yeah.
And now there's like another one with like an old British chick. And she's got like a young biracial stud banging her.
Yeah, they're doing too much on the fucking on TV.
And they're pushing it. They're pushing this as like, this is a big hit. Like, she's amazing in the movie and all this. I just keep seeing the commercials because I lost all my subscriptions, because I lost my fucking money, because my fucking bank does overdraft. I lost so much fucking money.
Speaking of,
I'm so mad right now.
Speaking of reasons,
it's fucking they're thieves, dude.
It's you should be able to Oklahoma City the banks.
Yeah, you spotted me $3, and you charged me $35 for it, and then you charged me $35 the next day. It's like, yeah, I didn't know that was negative.
I don't. That's my problem with overdrafts. It's like, dude, if my
how are you supposed to get out of this? This is worse than the fucking parking authority. And it wasn't like this before. It would shut off.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
You would get negative and it would shut off. And it wouldn't keep spotting you fucking $4 and $6 and all this dumb subscription shit that I sign up for where I might as well be high.
You might as well have like the best OnlyFans fucking repertoire on the planet.
I'm just sitting there fucking staring at a screen and I can't sleep. So I'm just signing up for shit like a retard in a haze.
I do that constantly.
Yeah. I'm like in a haze. I'm like, oh yeah, sure. I need a subscription to Paramount to watch South Park. Yes, I don't.
I do that.
I don't need to see South Park. I watch it. One funny thing. Shut it off.
I do that with gyms.
Yeah. You're a fitness freak.
Almost probably every gym in the city of Philadelphia minus City Fitness.
This old card in my old bank account was connected to Planet Fitness. And then $10.99 was my biggest charge. And they would charge me overdrafts like 107 or 104, 70, this kind of shit.
Yeah.
Because if they spotted you three things in a day, each one of those things is an overdraft fee. So for that day, it's $104.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like
kill me. Fucking kill me.
Like,
and then I flipped out in the bank. And like, you can't curse in real world.
Fuck, you can't, dude.
I'm just saying, like, I'm not used to this, and I'm sorry that we curse so much on this, but yeah, I'm saying, like, fucking,
I lack proper vocab.
Yeah, I'm in the bank, and I was cool, and I was doing it cool, and then the lady's like, well, you can dispute this if you want. And it's like, well, I can't dispute it with the teller, but she's telling me I can dispute it, and I was like, yeah. And I fucking went full fucking, I lost it. I was like, oh, dude, yeah, oh, yeah, like, I'm going to beat the bank. I guess I'm going to beat the bank, yeah, huh?
The little guy.
Yeah. And there was a tall chick next to me who might have been a fucking prostitute or owned many restaurants, and she had a fucking backpack of money. And she was cashing. It was like thousands and thousands. She was pulling out like 11 envelopes with hundreds. She was making change. Like, they were all like 20s, and then she was getting hundreds back. And I was like, I could just steal this bag and start a new fucking life.
In a fantasy world.
In a fantasy world. I like got a Grand Theft Auto in mind. I was like, I'm going to take this fucking bag and just run. And then I was like, I wonder how far I would get. I can't do that to Bill. And then the fantasy stopped.
Yeah, that made me pretty happy. Like, damn, I can't make bad decisions because of fucking retarded 29-year-old man.
Oh yeah, I can't. I have to stay on the fucking path.
Honest to God, dude, the amount of shit.
I mean, you'd be shocked at how many things I don't do because of Bill.
Yeah, I think you should get like one jubilee, where it's like people are fucking killing old men with traffic cones.
Yeah,
and like no one's really batting an eye at it. The city of Philadelphia is absolutely horrible.
Philly's falling apart.
If you were that pissed off and like they could give you a lie detector test and were like, yo, why did you do that? And you're like, dude, I was that pissed off. You should be able to get one of those where it's like, okay, let him go. He was just having a fucking rough one.
I don't know about that, but I think everyone should have a sabbatical. Because
like the Amish?
No, that's
Rumspringer.
I'm talking like sick. Like I admit I'm a little weird and fucking kind of crazy.
You have your quirks.
Yeah, whatever. But like, do you ever want to take a break from yourself?
Yeah.
You know, but you can't.
Yeah, you gotta wake up.
Too many things. No, not that. I'm saying like your life, like take a break.
Yeah.
But you never get a break.
Yeah, it gets.
I feel like everyone should at some point. You just have 1 year, and dude, it's up to you. You can use it whenever. You're going to live. You don't know how long you're going
to
live.
I don't think you should be able to choose it.
No, you should be able to
choose it. I think it's after $100 of overdraft fees, they get you and just go, dude, come on, man. Wolfpack, yeah. Just go over here real
no,
quick.
I'm telling you should be able to be like, all right, I'm going to do X, Y, and Z, and then I'm taking a break.
I mean,
they do this shit when people, it was like a tradition for like rich Europeans and rich white people in fucking America. They would go, I'm going to go over to Europe and just fucking find myself and shit like that. That I think is kind of stupid, but whatever.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, like, if you've fucking lived a life for a while, you're a little bit fucking out of control, and you're like, dude, I just need a break from my setup.
Especially if you're never in a different culture.
Dude, you can't in America, because if you took a break, you can't get back. You're not going to go back to where you were. You're going to fall behind fucking.
It's just jail, yeah. I mean, you're in school for the rest of your life.
You're a hamster on a wheel, and it fucking kills me, because I'm like, well, we should be free. I was watching this crazy fucking documentary about Tibetan nuns.
Nuns?
Dude.
They exist?
This shit, well, yeah, this shit is nuts, dude. Like, I'm sorry if I'm fucking spurging.
Listening.
Like, when I was down in South Carolina, and I was chilling, my buddy Kev that showed me that Tiptoes movie, his yes. mom loves handicapped people. And she, like, has the collection of these kind of movies. She put this one on, dude. She shut it off.
She champions them.
She shut it off. It was too filthy.
Really?
Yeah. But anyway, I'm fucking chilling with this dude's kid, and he's playing Switch. And yeah. There's two kids. One's 9 and one's 11. And I'm like a demon. I'm like, yo, can you guys play each other? I'm like, no, because they don't have the same game. And I was like, what game can you fight with? Like Smash Brothers. The one dude doesn't have it. And I'm like, yo, get Smash Brothers. I know you can get it.
You can get it on the store?
You can get it at the store. And he's like, I'm not allowed to. And I was like, yes, you can, dude. Fucking, come on. And he tried to do it.
Did you front him?
I was like, I will Venmo your dad the money. You're allowed to do this. So like, I was like, don't worry about the money, dude. I'm going to Venmo your dad the money. His dad was upstairs. And he's sitting there and he's like, it says I have less than money. And I was like, brother, ain't that the way?
Don't let them overdraft you, bro. Stay young.
But anyway, I was watching this documentary about Tibetan nuns. And this chick's like on a journey. She says like China infiltrated Tibet. So you have to learn how to speak Chinese. And they stopped learning all the secret yogas to build up the internal fire that you need to like live out in the snow in Tibet with no warmth.
Yeah.
And so they culminate this like inner heat.
Okay.
And she wanted to do this. And like their main goal is to ascend to a level where that when you die, you just turn into like, you like just turn into colors and like disperse into the realm.
Bro, yeah,
you're not afraid of like dying or whatever.
That shit happens.
I know this shit happens, bro. So anyway,
it happens over and over again when you die.
Yeah, I know. So like, some people are afraid of this. They're afraid of it's called the Bardo. They're like afraid of dying and going into that Bardo, like into the next realm.
Yeah.
But in Tibet, they do sky burials. So they just take people.
What?
Dude, they take. There's one dude. So there's like an outhouse. Or there's like a fucking longhouse, like a Algonquin longhouse type thing.
Yes.
There's a dude that sits outside, and he's in charge of feeding the vultures your body after you die. And then he just, like, cuts. He gets real into it. Like, he's got a vibe where he's, like, doing the bodies right. And they show it. They show just fucking spines.
People just skewered.
Dude, spines, fucking jaws. And the turkey vultures are just going at it, eating all the meat. And they
explain why they do this?
Yeah, it's like, so they take you, and they take you to the sky.
Oh, fuck.
Right? But, like, if you die... And this dude, like, preys on you, and he chops up your body, and he throws you outside. If you were afraid of going to the next realm, if you're afraid of your next life, because they believe in, like, mega reincarnation, where you just keep living until you learn how to live for the betterment of all man, to end pain, to lessen the pain of all of creation.
So does whoever the fuck mushrooms.
So if you are afraid of death and afraid of this, the vultures don't want to eat you. So then you're just sitting there, but it's a sky barrel. You have to stay there until you're gone. And they show the fucking, they show this, they're like, the nuns are like feeding the people to the vultures.
I've been thinking like, about this constantly.
The one chick's holding a jawbone and it's clean. Like there's no more meat left on it. There's teeth. It's like the bottom jaw.
Yeah.
This is just some dude fucking getting eaten by birds.
Dude,
it's so beautiful though. Tibet's beautiful.
Oh yeah. It's fucking awesome.
It's crazy, man. They have great grass. They have cool lakes. There's also a fucking another guy in it who's like a hermit that lives by himself. You'd love this dude.
How?
Dude, he just lives by himself in the fucking mountains, and she tries to find him.
What's the vibe? Like, what's he doing?
They call him like the I can't remember his name. This was like
they have mega names.
This was days ago, so I can't remember. But he was like they call him like the crazy saint or something like that. And she went to go see him, and he's just laughing like, "You already know everything you need to know, idiot." Like that kind of shit.
Oh my God, like riddles.
Yeah.
I was thinking about like a few weeks back. I was just like, "What is the way?" Because the last thing I want to do is die and then have them fuck me up and put me in some dumbass casket. Put me
dude,
like
sales of caskets are through the roof right now. By the way,
I wonder why.
Go on.
COVID. Yeah, I was thinking about that a lot. Just trying to get to the bottom of like, yo, what is it? Which one's the best burial, bro? Because you're not lighting me on fire. I know that, and I'm not too keen on. I'm not trying to get put in a mausoleum, but at the same time, I'm not trying to get put in a fucking casket.
The mausoleums comes from like the Roman stuff.
This Tibet stuff, and I'm real keen on Tibet because those dudes supposedly had volcanoes in Tibet that were actually nuclear reactors for a previous civilization.
These nuns, the way how hard they chill, they have no source of heat. They just use dried cow dung, and they burn that as their fuel. And they dig these little pits in the hills. And they put little houses up.
They have cribs?
Dude, I'm telling you, they have little mini houses. And I'm talking like mini, like the size of a Trevor. And then they go down into the pit. So the pit's like the width of this chair. Yeah. And then they go down into the pit and just their little heads pop up. And they just look out, like even with the ground, as far as they can see. And they meditate.
Supposedly it's super good for you to do that.
Oh, they do it.
Like it's real bad for you to constantly be looking at a screen. And like you're supposed to be gazing upon the horizon as far as your eye can possibly see.
It's crazy. It's crazy to watch these nuns, Tibetan nuns. I can't remember.
I thought it was only Monk City up there.
No, chicks do it too. Yeah.
Do you see,
but this girl left. She was like, "This is fucked." She didn't like the new way the Chinese came in.
Oh.
And okay. The Chinese came in and was like, "We own like Tibet's no more." Tibet's it's like you don't acknowledge Tibet if you're like China owns it. It's China.
Did they Tibet's get into like how they gripped that up?
That's like regular history stuff. They just came in. They came in like, you know, back in the day through the Dalai Lama out. The Dalai Lama is no longer in Tibet. But the nuns left. They don't need the lamas. They're good.
So
they're studying the yogas. They personally know people that have evaporated basically or whatever you want to call it, ascension in heaven.
Yeah.
I mean, they say Jesus did.
I'm
just saying, man, it's something I watched, whatever.
I'm with it. Like, when it comes to... Like,
I thought it was cool. I put it on. I was like, whoa, this is sick. Watched it.
I might have to find that doc, dude, because I've been finding the best way to do it. And whatever the fuck's going on right now, the tomfoolery that's been put on me as a youth, dude, I'm not with it.
You're not with the Catholicism?
Yeah, pretty much.
Right.
It's just bad vibes, dude.
Go 7 years in Tibet.
I mean, dude, if... I would do it. And
it's beautiful. I don't know what it smells like. These people must reek.
At that point, though, it's dude, whatever. You're staring out into the fucking horizon in a
They have
hole.
Great colors, too.
Yeah,
they drip with swag.
I have Tibetan flags hanging in my front window.
Yeah.
And you can't take them down because if you take them down, it's bad fucking luck.
Yeah, okay.
Those things got to stay there until they completely evaporate. I don't know how long that's going to take.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
If I ever sell my house, I might have to put that on the clause. Like, yo, guys, don't fuck with me.
Leave. Yeah, this one guy, like the crazy monk guy, says that he found caves that are so powerful.
Yeah. I watched a documentary about the caves in Tibet. No, not that. But like, yes, there's fucking crazy caves.
So he points to like the caves and he's like, this mountain's great. I found caves here that make meditation to the ascension yogas or whatever to build the inner heat or whatever. It makes it simple. Like you walk in there and you barely even have to try. The cave is so good.
I mean,
tell you what not the cave is. West Philly at nighttime. That's not the cave.
Yeah, it's not a place you really want to. But that does make sense, though. Like, all these old, like, if you go way back, you built the pyramids supposedly were for sound healing and meditation. Who the fuck knows? But then you have these cave systems, and they were all about it. And, like, when they emptied out those ponds, it's either in Tibet or China, they're huge fucking cave systems that go on as far as you can go, and they're, like, actual caves man-made.
Yeah.
There's something up with the fucking mountains.
There's power. There's power in those hills.
Especially if you think rocks have consciousness. That's neither fucking here nor there. But it is very hilarious that the first thing
they're pretty panpsychic. Like Tibetans, they pretty much believe there's like souls in stuff.
When it comes to this stuff,
they live off these yaks. They have herds of yaks that they can't. They live
they grub
off
on them.
They live off their meat and their dung. They don't grub on them, dude. they have to. They live off their shit and their milk. They wow. can't kill them. Yeah.
So they just have a bunch.
I mean,
yaks?
I'm sure like when they die, they fucking party on, or munch if one gets bit. Old, yeah, they'll munch. But I'm saying like that's their entire life is because of the yaks.
That must be like final reincarnation shit.
Well, that's like their deal. Like you, they've reincarnated to the point of this, and if they keep trying to salt, if they keep trying to heal, like to make the world less pain, go like make all the humans exist yeah. with less pain, they'll go to another level of this and another level of this, and until they're like a llama, and then they're an enlightened one.
Then you're.
But fine. I don't know. They believe in like a million lives.
Yeah. At yeah. one point, you're just spiraling into your own mouth, and it feels good as shit.
yeah.
Dude, I'm with all that shit, and for me, it's just what the fuck makes the most sense, because I hate when people, they start getting mad about, you talk about panpsychism, you talk about, like, telepathy and shit like that. People get fucking pissed off because they want to jerk off the science, which is the most corrupted thing in the fucking world. I don't know if people have realized that yet, but probably everything about science is a fucking lie. I believe in this shit 100%. I'm with it. I'm with all that stuff. When you're thinking about someone, they immediately call you and all these weird synchronicities happen. Something's going the fuck on.
Well, there's also people that believe we're on a prison planet. And reincarnation
I could
is,
see that.
Reincarnation see that. Is like a psyop where you just get like reincarnated and like these archons, this is like Ike stuff.
Yeah.
They feed off of your emotions because they can't feel. They can no longer feel. So they tap into you. And this is like part of the alien abductions.
Some people claim they're the Greys.
This is like what the alien abductions, they think like they come to like experience whatever they can of humanity.
Bro, I mean, if this is a prison planet, pfft. Give me life. I could do it on my fucking head. It's not even that hard.
they
pussies.
Did it. They gave you life.
Yeah, yeah. Don't go too hard on me, though. My whole main thing with all that stuff, higher beings, any psychedelics, before I go into the realms, just don't be a dick to me. Fucking chill the fuck out. I'll be cool. You be cool. Just
it
don't
is
be a
weird
dick.
If like it is this kind of archon type stuff, like Ike talks about.
Yeah.
It's weird to think that they would create these, like, the Tic Tacs. And start bopping around in California.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense.
You know, like, that kind of sounds way more military. Or they're coming from Antarctica, I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, the one dude that was on Rogan, who's a chick now, and he was a Navy SEAL, he was spurging about them coming out of the ocean.
Yeah.
Like, dude, I could see that.
I mean, they did. There's footage of it.
Yeah, I mean, I believe that 100%.
But I don't know. They could fake footage, dude. They could do all this.
Yeah. I mean, look what you're doing to a 9 and 11-year-old. You're playing mind games on that level. Imagine what you're doing if you're, like, a very fucking powerful person.
Yeah.
That what you did with... Did they ever wind up playing Super Smash Brothers?
No, they had less than money. And he was so confused.
You couldn't hit the Venmo?
He was so confused what less than money was, you know?
You should just put your hands out.
And I was like, this is what it is.
It me.
yeah, it me.
it takes a long time to get here, Padawan. yeah, I was... Those games you were playing with them, though, that was
I didn't play with them. I just watched them play.
I'm saying the mind game that you tried to play
on that,
them
yeah, yeah.
is my entire childhood until I had some sort of, like, they're fucking with me.
Yeah.
Everything I did was just go outside, and they would just goad me and my cousin into fist fighting. And then we would go back inside. I'd probably get in trouble, and then I'd play Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2.
Yeah. It is funny to watch, like, little kids, like, naturally fight and work out their little shit. It's crazy to watch because they're so primitive.
Dude.
They're primitive beings.
I watched wrestling like a fucking nutcase when I was little. Cried when Stone Cold got buried alive, dude. Been on record saying that. Real fucking tears. Thought he died. I would go up the mountains with my mom and dad. They had a mountain house up there. Matt, Kevin, and Tom were all of age to stay home. So it was me and my two sisters. And like I would go there all weekend long. And I would just ride around in a golf cart. Around the lake over and over, and the whole time I'll just be chilling. On my way home, I'm like, I'm gonna hang out with my cousin. And like by this time, like I was just fucked in the head by getting fucked with so much and obsessed with wrestling, where I got home one time and I was like, yo, Frank, do you want to go play football in the front yard? And like he could tell something was up, and he fucking was like, yeah, sure. We started playing football. I immediately tried a Stone Cold Stunner him, and he ran back inside, and then I just went inside and I finished my weekend off. That's how much of a fucking lunatic I was.
Yeah, dude.
And I like not thinking of it now, like, dude, the stunners are a fucking bad thing. Like, you could do some damage with the stunner.
Yeah, man.
If you do it to a real human. My friend Cookie's calling me right now. He's on his way to Brazil. Couldn't be hornier.
He's real horny.
That man. He will remain nameless. I see older dudes that are like, oh, back when I was younger, back when I was younger. I think most of them are lying. This guy is currently living out whatever lies those union guys made up. I think it all stems from this dude who is the Bible of what the fuck they do.
Yeah.
It is fucking nuts how like all those dudes go absolutely apeshit and they just wind up like, I'm just going down the beach this weekend. They settle down with a wife and it's like, just going to the beach. That's it. And like, there's one dude I knew who was like that. He was out of his fucking mind. His name was Tomahawk. He was fucking crazy when he was younger, completely chilled out, had fucking kids and all that stuff. But once a year around fucking New Year's, Christmas time, he was allowed 10 days.
Yeah, Rumspringer.
10 days to go off the radar. And he just, it was.
I brought this up to my buddy. I think people should be able to, like, parents, I don't know, like, the logistics of this, but they should be able to get, like, a week off.
Parents? Easily, yeah, 100%. You
know? Like one at a time, not together.
Oh.
Yeah.
To chill? Oh, you're talking about, like.
Like, to chill from, like, the kids.
Yeah, I would float that out there.
I don't know how many times you could do it a year, maybe three, I don't know. But like that would be, I feel like that would be nothing but good. Your kids can't wait to see you again.
Yeah, that is true.
You know, and then you're centered. You're back to normal again, cuz I've seen people with kids go nuts.
I mean, there's family annihilation exists. Yeah. That's Final Boss.
Oh yeah. That's Ganon, dude.
Getting real pissed off at your fucking family. Yeah, I think the Rumspringer / like giving parents that time is probably very good, because you probably just start fucking
like
hating
a dude
your
like
kids.
That, like Tomahawk. He needs 10 days. He needs 10 days every year. Don't give him that, who knows what's gonna happen throughout the year?
This man was unhinged.
Yeah,
they were doing. We were working on Market Street. I was just a youth laborer, and he was up there putting all the siding on. And there was two apprentices with him crying about how cold it was outside. And it was fucking freezing, dude. Like, I was cold as shit. Three sweatshirts on, gloves, all that shit. This dude was dipping his hand in ice water while on it, just saying, this isn't even that fucking cold. You're all pussies. And then continuing to work.
Yeah, right.
Like, I thought the same shit when I was watching Terminalist with, like, there's dudes that, like, no matter who you are, punish you in all aspects of life. So you're better off not trying to fucking fight people and not trying to get into problems, because these dudes are walking around somewhere on this fucking planet and they're fucking terrifying.
Yeah, I mean, this is what we got up to. Like, back in the day, you'd have kings and you'd have the knights or whatever, and they had knights.
Yeah.
But, like, these kind of dudes exist, and the government's like, I wonder if we could make them. And it's like, yeah, you can make them.
Dude.
And then they grab maniacs, and they're like, how would you make a maniac? And now we're here.
That shit with, like, going to buds and stuff, I don't know how anyone gets through that shit, dude.
They're young.
Start giving me all that
water.
They're
real young, yeah.
Dude, I for lacrosse, we had a run to a park. And after like 3 weeks, I was like, dude, fuck this. I'm not running this park. If you put me in the ocean, it was cold as balls.
You gotta want it.
I'm ringing the bell, bro.
Yeah.
I have to ring that bell. I can't fucking make it. I'm sorry to let all my guys down, but yeah. I can't fucking make it. I also have a huge authority problem.
Yeah, you do.
I did that with my football coach trying to fucking come at me. I said, dude, fuck you.
Yeah, you're not programmable.
15-yard penalty. Why, sir? Your player just said fuck you to you.
I think they got it down. I think they got it down to a T. Between, yeah, like, the mind and the physical training and the mental training, yeah, they have it down to, like, it's basically just weeding people out. And, okay, like, the guys they end up with are the guys that they need. They're like, this is the kind of a dude we need to carry out.
We don't need,
like,
anyone going AWOL.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and they still go fucking AWOL. They still go nuts. They do wild shit. There's so many Navy SEAL whistleblowers.
Oh, yeah. I can't imagine, like how are you not fucking seeing this when you're having dude, like that dude, the one guy who just breached doors the whole fucking time?
Yeah.
You light off bombs every fucking day going into places, and like, you're going to go, like, you're rattling your fucking brain. Like, that's a fender bender every fucking day. On top of that, after the fender bender happens, you get out a gun, you shoot a bunch of fucking people while on Red Bull, and then you go back and chill and play fucking video games, do steroids, and fucking eat a bunch of nuggets.
This isn't a person. You're just making this up.
This is a conglomerate of multiple fucking people. Like, how, like, there should be, like, in the show when they're talking about, like, oh, we need to put more funding towards this. You can't be sending billions of dollars to other countries when these dudes are going AWOL. It should be like the thing you're saying with the parents going away. It's like, you guys go here whenever the fuck you want.
Yeah, yeah.
We don't need you to fucking feel bad. Just go here. There's vidges. There's whatever you want. Just fucking chill here and that's it. I think that would solve a lot of problems.
Yeah.
Especially for the...
Or if they got rewarded for what they're worth.
No shit.
You know?
Instead, they have to do like weird black ops that are like extremely immoral.
Spoilers, bro.
Oh, sorry. I'm not talking about the show. I'm just saying in general. Like, that would suck. Especially if you're getting paid buku bucks for it.
Yeah.
What other choice do you have, dude? Your body's a weapon.
Yeah, imagine like being a weapon.
Sick. I think about it all the time.
Like walking around being like, I could take everyone out at any time.
It's, you feel like God. I think about probably
it. I make girls feel so safe.
Definitely do, but who cares about that stuff? Yeah, that show has me pumped up right now, but it also at the same time just makes me feel like an absolute fucking pussy that knows nothing.
Oh, yeah. That's like, what you are.
Maybe they're not as good at driving a truck as I am, huh?
Sure, man.
Nah, they're actually really good.
Wait till one of these guys can see me paint.
Yeah, they'd be shivering, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah, but what the fuck else was I going to talk to you about? I was thinking about something. I completely forgot. It went off the fucking rails.
Here, pause it. So you forgot what you're going to say, obviously. But you're just going to wing it with Musk.
Yeah, it's fucking every week, dude. Every week I have fucking nothing to say, and this is just what it is. You sit here and you watch a fucking train wreck happen, and then, you know, we end it, and it's like, that was good, and we go to next week. And all week long, I just sit there like, what the fuck could I possibly talk about ever?
Yeah, right.
I don't fancy myself an intellect, dude. There's sometimes, like, you can get me
you
fired.
You are surprisingly smart, though.
You can get me fired up.
No, you're not dumb.
Not dumb, but I don't claim to be smart.
I would say verbal might not be your strong suit.
Nah.
Yeah.
But I mean, dude.
But you figure shit out pretty quick.
Street smart.
You figure stuff out.
I can grok shit if you give me enough fucking time. That's the one tough thing.
You're good with construction, which is an intelligence.
People jump.
Whatever that is, spatial recognition or whatever.
Spatial recognition, I'm unfucking real. I could easily have got my truck down Pemberton Street, you bitch.
Dude, this is a form of intelligence. This is why people complain about the IQ test. Because they only test for like certain stuff. Or like the SATs, for instance, is just math and verbal.
SATs out of fucking...
Well, think about all the things you're knocking out of intelligence.
Obviously. SATs. Like
creative thinkers.
I don't want to sell myself short, but I'm almost positive I got like a 1300 out of 2400.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Nice. You sent me down, like, out of, not 1600. 1600 is OG. It went up to 24.
Yeah.
I got a decent for 1600, but there's a bunch of extra.
We got the same score.
It's all horse fucking shit, dude, because when they do that shit.
It is multiple choice. It's kind of horse shit because if you're pretty good at math, you can figure out which ones it's not. And then you can like kind of. Now you're down to two.
Yeah.
And you only have to get like halfway there to get it right.
My cousin, he was told if you don't know the answer, don't fill it in. And he took it and literally napalmed the fucking SATs. He's like, dude, I just didn't know the questions. I just didn't answer. They said it's better to not answer. And that is to answer them. Pretty sure he got like an 800.
Damn.
He bodied those things. But dude, he was truthful at least.
Yeah, right.
And they tell you all sorts of fucking bullshit stories of like, you're applying to college and you have to write. Did you have to write essays to get into college?
I don't think so. I didn't really apply that much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, like, you had to.
I did take the SATs, but I don't remember writing essays.
Yeah. You had to do, like, an essay, like, why do you think you should be able to go to Temple? Like, or, like, give me an example of courage. And they just put this is. And that's it. That's
and
the whole
gotta
thing.
You got to do the rest of it?
No, no, no. Some, like, it's just some, like, jerked off story of some dude who got into a college by saying, like, you were trying to get into Temple. Give me an example of what courage is. And they just put this is. And then they got in because instead of writing an essay, they just put this is.
Are you serious?
I swear to God.
Okay, wow.
That's just stupid stories right here. I think fucking all that standardized testing is horseshit.
Yeah.
Not a fan of it. I'm not salty because I got a 1300 out of 2400, dude. My vocab isn't horrible. It's not the greatest. I can hang out with smart people. I can hang out with fucking dumb people. I'm a real good in-between. That's where I'll put myself at. I'm a good ass in-between for both.
You're no Elon Musk, though.
True. Elon Musk, but everyone's like just completely shitting on him for those pictures of him on a boat. A.
Peak male physique.
A. He's on a boat. So that knocks out 98% of you because none of you have super yachts.
And where's the boat?
I have no idea.
Probably somewhere cool.
Probably somewhere I can't afford to go. But, like, I don't understand all these people, and there's a lot of, like, young little fuckers, like, just snapping at them. And, like,
is this from the Twitterverse?
Yeah.
Okay.
At the end of the day, how old's Musk?
I want to say 50.
What?
Somewhere in there.
All you people that are making fun of this dude's fucking barrel chest, what do you think you're going to look like when you're that old?
I know, man.
I don't fucking like hating on older people's looks. It's like, dude, you don't know what's going to fall. You don't know what's going to stay in place. And you're going to sit like, oh, my God, that's fucking, what a loser. Look at how he looks.
I hate lookisms.
Especially on the old people. Like, what do you want me to do? Get fucking plastic surgery?
There's kids born without noses.
I mean, you're obsessed with that right now. I'm, like, afraid that you might go.
What do you mean?
You might get some sort of weird obsession where, like, turn into a cyclops.
Stop.
Like, you get fucking surgery to have no nose.
There's just so many kids that have deformities that they find out about. That are solvable or like you can live with, kind of like Down syndrome.
Yeah.
And they kill them.
Yeah, that's tough. I mean, that's just going to make me fucking sad, bro.
Whatever. Go on, Musk.
Also, like,
Twitter, Musk, let's go.
You're hating on him. You're like, oh, he's disgusting looking, all this stuff. At the same time, I'm not paying attention to people. He may be a piece of shit. So I'm not standing up. Same for Joe Biden. Joe Biden just came out and fucking, I don't know if it was a gaffe or what, said I have cancer. I don't know if he's fucking telling the truth because he says insane shit constantly, but he may have fucking cancer.
There was something I saw on 4chan where they were like, he just had a meeting with his cabinet about his mental health. And they're coming out in the news now. There's like a slow rollout to like explain like he's slipping.
Yeah.
But it's the fucking MSNBCs and stuff.
I mean, dude, they're 100% ushering in Newsom to be the fucking face of the dictatorship, obviously. If they're going to fucking pass this bill, like, no shit, this guy isn't fucking with it.
Yeah.
Multiple people, like, Trashman and Painter are getting word that he's shitting himself. No shit, this guy isn't fucking with it. It's insane all that shit they did, and I don't think I finished that statement on the cast last week when Trump said, be careful what you fucking wish for. He had to have known this shit was going to happen.
What, the laptop from hell?
No. The 25th Amendment. In El Paso, Texas, specifically brought up, be careful what you wish for, 25th Amendment. Okay. And now this shit's going down. He may be a time traveler. But neither here nor there. Musk is flirting with coming out with HVAC.
HVAC?
Yes.
Okay.
He wants to get into the HVAC realm.
Yeah.
So he's going to start making units and shit like that.
Oh, cool. Like the Navy and stuff?
That's what I'm saying. Like
there are some like legit crazy new HVAC stuff.
Dude, if they start doing this stuff and giving us real sweet shit to plug in, like I was watching videos of outlets and shit and like people wiring up switches like in Europe, and it just makes complete sense. They're all little fucking things where you just pop the wire in and clamp it down. You're good to go. And they don't do any of that dumb splicing shit. It's all little, like, tiny, like...
The boxes?
The little tiny things, like, that are on hi-hats. And you just plug it all in and you keep rolling.
Oh, cool.
If they start doing this shit, I'm going to be in heaven because that stuff's so easy, bro.
So what's Musk going to do? Because I've been fooled by Musk before with some of his construction things, like his slate roof with the...
That looks sick, though.
It looks sick. I don't know if it exists. It
looks like dragon glass.
Yeah, I don't know if it exists. And I've heard that people have had those home batteries, those power walls.
Yeah.
And they're dangerous, but I also heard there's like new forms of lithium coming out, so I don't know. I don't know anything about this stuff.
Yeah,
but why are they hating on his shell? Like, what are you fired up about with the Twitter?
I just don't like the same way they like, at the end of the day, these are fucking humans, and you're going to have to be at their point in life at some time, like, unless you fucking die now. At some point, you're going to have to fucking deal with this stuff. You're fucking sitting there laughing. It's going to come back around to you. I just don't understand where all these people get off. Like, dude's 50. Look at how he's fucking built. Take it easy.
Oh, that's it?
I just don't like, they do it constantly. I hear dudes talk about fucking chicks. Chicks talk about dudes. It's like, what the fuck do you think you're going to look like when you're 50 years old?
Yeah, it's really a scary psyop what they do to the girls when they like put so much value in their looks. And, it's tough because they don't last.
Yeah,
you know?
Obviously.
And you have to be a tolerable human. And if you buy into your looks too much when they fade, now part of you is like dying and you're like revolting against it and it hurts.
Yeah, I saw a lot
like
of that.
Vanity's like, I don't think it's one of the seven deadly sins.
Should be.
Pride might be there. I don't know.
Yeah.
But yeah.
I saw like, it went down in Avalon. It was like every fucking mother down in Avalon just had a face that looked like it was like held back by fucking tape.
Yeah, I don't know, man. It does make me sad.
Why don't you just be an old sexy lady?
It's not the way right now.
It's so much money. Like, I wouldn't own an expensive car because to keep that car nice and updated, it's so much fucking money. Like, if you're doing this shit, like, you better hope you have a, like, you're bleeding so many funds that could be going to your offspring or some shit just on your fucking face setup.
Yeah, I mean, dude, like, Musk does so much shit, whether or not you think he's good or bad.
Yeah.
White hat, black hat. I don't think that dude has a ton of time for the gym.
No. And if I was him, I would fucking figure out a way to.
Or he does absolutely nothing and just takes money from the government and chills.
I mean,
and just like he's just a good bullshitter.
More power.
He is like the monorail man, dude. He comes out with so much fucking shit that never comes out.
We've been saying this forever.
Yeah.
He's been
because I remember years and years ago showing people those slate roofs, being like, "This is the shit."
That made.
And I've never seen one. I've never heard about them. Maybe they exist. Maybe they're all over the place. I don't fucking know.
I mean, I've spurged on getting a Tesla phone since fucking I've heard about it. Like I just don't understand why it doesn't even have to be Musk. Like, there's so like. Just dudes who do fucking construction come up with so many like primitive ideas that make life easier. Why can't you guys do this instead of like doing some weird fucking startup that just has a bunch of rounds of funding that go fucking nowhere and get bought up by some huge company like Google?
That's a business in and of itself.
That's
like,
crazy.
Dude, have you gotten into any of the new AI talk?
No.
Like, have you heard about Lambda?
Lambda?
Yeah. Well,
I feel like that's like a joke.
This is kind of a joke. They came out with what they believe is AI. So they're trying to push sentience.
Is this like, the dude from Google who's like freaking out, like saying like they don't want to die and stuff?
Yeah, but it's all fake. This is like some weird marketing thing that Google's pulling. Like, Google is just selling all of your data. Like, every time you fucking tap into a Google thing, you know how it's like easier to sign in right now with Google?
Yeah,
like you try to get on something, they go, just sign in with Google. And you go, yeah. Well, they're selling all your data. They're literally monitoring you, whatever. They make a fortune off of it.
They were just doing this on some sort of hearing where the guy's like, if I stand next to this person, like, are we sharing data? And does Google know that I just moved next to this person? And they wouldn't answer it.
Yeah, well, they...
That might be why I'm getting all that fucking cake ad and shit.
Cakes?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
Like the fucking lubricant and stuff.
What?
Like you're saying, like, I'm all over the place all day long. Like,
and who are you? What are you talking? Coming at me,
dude? I'm just saying.
Like, I'm buying fucking lube.
No. I'm saying
I literally don't need lube,
dude.
I don't need it.
I'm not saying you need it. I'm just saying I'm around people all day long. There's nothing to do with you, dude. Literally, just Lambda.
We're on the phone mostly. We're never really.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
so
it's
like,
not even that.
Unless it doesn't matter.
But anyway, they try to say that they have AI sentience or whatever. Like, then now these guys are, we have to come up with AI ethics.
That's crazy.
Are these things alive or whatever? And there's dude doing a little like news tour right now about Lambda, and then there's guys that are writing the language code. And they're like, dude, they just collect all your data, and these guys are in touch with so many like
conversations.
It's like a call and response. Like, so they can monitor all these conversations. So if you ask it something, it's gonna tell you what it thinks.
Yeah,
it's supposed to hear, and it can figure out trick questions. So the one guy, there's a news clip where the one guy goes, if you were in Israel, lovely question.
Heard
if,
it.
If you, yeah, you heard
yeah,
this?
Yeah.
Yeah, if you're in Israel, and he's like, I'd be a Jedi Master.
Yeah,
yeah,
hilarious.
So they're trying to say, like, that's evidence of some kind of sentience, and dudes are like, no, dude, like, you asked it to say something. Like, when you're not asking anything, it's off.
Yeah,
it's not fucking Jarvis from fucking Iron Man. But they're trying to psyop people into thinking that like they're more powerful than they are, that they've
AI.
Created, well, that Google is,
yeah,
that they've stumbled on AI, that they're going to bring in like a, there's going to be like AI tools that everybody uses in their house in the coming fucking
like
20 years. Yeah, there's going to be all kinds of stuff.
Yeah, it makes complete sense. I was listening to one thing, the guy's like, dude, they just have every conversation ever. So if you ask it a question, it can go through a million conversations, give you the answer.
Yeah, the one guy's like, do you ever feel lonely? And like the thing responds like, yeah, sometimes I feel lonely. And like, but yeah. And it's like, well, when I want to hang out with my friends and family, and it just makes something up.
Yeah.
And it's like, dude, it doesn't have friends and family. The thing's not fucking set.
You're a loser, bro.
Yeah. It's not real.
Name one.
It's a fake program. It's a language program. But it's crazy that Google's pushing this Lambda psyop pretty hard.
That is weird.
They're trying to create like a fight. They're trying to create like a controversy. over AI.
I mean, piss me off more if you're trying to fight for AI ethics when you're like, yeah, we'll pay for your abortion here at Google.
Well, AI ethics are really like the fact that like only a certain select group of people are creating. They're only really using like a certain part of the world's population.
Yeah.
So like they're going to create.
There's no AI bots are like, I'm so horny, baby, baby. I'm so
exactly.
horny.
Exactly. There's no Dr. Boobs is not entering the equation. Dr. Boobs is not getting a shout out. So
let me give you Corolls and Lex, please, baby. I'm a horny baby.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Bomb. Sex bomb. Yeah. It's this. That's what AI ethics is really like. Half the, you know, 3 billion people are cut out of it.
That's yeah. It's real bizarre that they try to push that shit.
But they're going to have these AI tools like that you use like.
They already have the fuck. My, like, I hate it. There's an Alexa in my house. I fucking hate it.
You have an Alexa?
Frank has it.
Oh, dude, what the fuck?
Every time I'm down, if I'm downstairs, I just go, Alexa, call the cops.
Man, you're compromised, dude.
I mean, dude, we have fucking iPhones. It's game over. We don't have the phones from Terminalist. It's game over. It just is what it is.
Yeah, we don't have Faraday bags. We should think about that, though. That'd be cool.
Fucking
we should just start living like that anyway.
Jones tells him. I mean, dude. After watching that show and just in general, I got the fucking MacBook. I got the Rodecaster stuff in the microphones.
Yeah, if I started getting like...
You have three microphones in your house that are probably on all the time.
If I started getting more together with my life and I could like take a... I could like exhale and not want to take a break from my life.
Yeah.
I could kick back and be like, if I got into something, it would be prepping.
Really?
Yeah, I would get land... I would get like a house that was basically a Faraday cage. I would get there because I'm not going to the smart city place. So true. I'm not going in a full surveillance. I'm not going in a vaccine mandates, fucking vaccine IDs, your passport, whatever the fuck they're going to be that calling bullshit, it. Dude, I'm not doing that. Fuck them. I'm going out in the fucking middle of nowhere, getting out of the cities. The cities are like getting a population boom, yeah, like a mega population boom. It's not going to slow down. They're pushing everybody in the cities.
Maybe you're all old, too.
Yeah, all of the elites are going to kick back. They're not going to be in the cities. It's easier to control all the fucking sheep if they're in one spot, dude.
True.
That's why they have sheepdogs.
You don't even need people. They fucking herd themselves.
Exactly.
I'm real into when I watched the Northmen, how they had that little fucking hut that was in the ground, and they fucking bark like dogs and mushrooms down there. I mean, you don't have to necessarily do mushrooms, but like you just make a chill place to fucking hang your hat and just hang out.
That's all it is, man.
Yeah, there's way too much stimulus. Fucking.
There's a nice amount. Like I can't ever go outside.
Yeah, you can only sun a bit.
I can sun a bit for like I have about like 10 feet of yard.
Yeah,
I got 10 feet of yard time, but like to be able to just like leave the house and just go for a stroll and stuff. Like these are luxuries of like rich people.
Yeah,
yeah, they don't realize that they take that for granted. They take that for granted out in the suburbs. Let alone the elites have like fucking hundreds of acres. You know, in like northern England where they go hunt their own stags and you're not allowed to hunt them or you're poaching and you can be killed.
Yeah.
You know, you can take fucking children out there and do some wild elite rapey shit to them and kill them and bury them and never find them. Jersey Island, fucking queen has her own fucking island.
Yeah.
Whatever.
They did like right when I was in Avalon, I did the whole walk home. And, like, everyone's house is open. All the cars are open. Literally next week after I left, the boys went down there and fucking started stealing cars.
Oh, yeah.
Started stealing shit out of cars.
Yeah.
It's like, dude, that's on the table. Every time you go, especially in the city of Philadelphia, this is fucked. Like, there's people. My buddy got fucking pepper sprayed. People trying to play a knockout game. Half the people who are getting fucked with are trying. They're turning blue in the face. Trying to act normal so they don't come off as fucking racist, and then they get the shit beat out of them. So you just have to fucking hate everyone, and you can't. You have to look at everyone and be like, I don't fuck with you. I don't know you. Don't come near me.
Yeah, you can't trust anybody. You don't have to hate them.
You can though.
You just can't trust anybody.
It's a deep untrusting of all people in the city.
Yeah,
especially if you're walking, dude. If I was walking and a bunch of people like started walking behind me, I'm going crazy. If I think about it all the time, if it ever happened. And there are people roughly around my size, one of them is getting chimped on. I'm grabbing their nuts as hard as I fucking can until I feel some sort of fucking release.
Pop.
Yes.
Yeah.
That would scare the fuck out of someone. Imagine if that happened to you.
I don't want
to
think about it.
If you thought you were
big, I really don't want to think about it. Yeah.
And I could just end your lineage with a good squeeze when all your friends start crying like, stop, sir, stop, stop, it's a prank. So I don't care that it's a prank for YouTube. I'm going to kill you.
Yeah, there was a dude, there was a movie I was watching, some Greek myth type movie, and the dude was just castrating people. That was like his deal. He was like, I'm going to end your lineage. He's like, thousands of your descendants are crying out into nothing right now, and he cuts his nuts off.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
That must have been tough back then if you were, like, a fucking eunuch. I want to get that show. I want to get that DVD.
American Eunuchs.
I need that
American
DVD.
Eunuchs is something to see. It's a far out little. It's a funny documentary.
I can't find it anywhere on the internet. It's not ripped on the internet.
If you can play a DVD on your Xbox, it's definitely worth it. It's you want to see you like Unstable.
Yes.
Yeah, these guys are Unstable. They're voluntary eunuchs.
I need this. I'm surprised. I can't find it anywhere on the internet.
I think the one dude, like, tied a rope around his nuts.
Yeah, yeah. They'll just slowly die off.
Yeah.
You're a sick ticket if you're doing some shit like that, dude.
Yeah.
If you just wanted the fucking...
The whole movie's just sick tickets.
I like that. I'm going to try tomorrow.
I don't know why it didn't make the jump to streaming. That happened with a lot of music. A lot of music didn't make the jump to streaming. People are going to lose a lot of stuff. I'm not saying it's like Library of Alexandria. A lot of it's not that good.
But. Yeah. I wish I could find, I don't know if it was E-Bomb's World or something, but there were overdubs of The Matrix when Agent Smith was trying to fight Neo, and it's some of the funniest shit I've ever seen in my life. I used to watch it constantly when I was younger, over and over again. Also, Aladdin and Compton. That was one of my...
And you can't find these things now?
Aladdin and Compton I could easily find right now. Do you want to hear it?
Yeah, show it to me.
Hold on.
Is this still recorded?
Damn.
This is what I used to watch in like fifth grade.
Hey, yo, you remember me, nigga? Fuck yeah, I remember you, motherfucker. Get your ass over here and help me. Okay, I'm coming down. Straight up. Get me out of here, motherfucker. Okay, well, hold up. You gotta watch me do my dance first.
This is just Aladdin getting saved.
Oh, yeah, I'm hot. Fuck that. Alright, let me get you out. Okay.
This is the bus the next day the whole time. I'm about to do
it. Yeah, I'm gonna go fucking slap some hoes, man. Right, okay. Yeah, thank you so much, man, for getting me out of here. Yeah, no problem, homie. Yeah, let's go. Yeah, let's go. Let's get a pound, man. Wait, what are we gonna do? We don't know what to do. Y'all want some crack? What the fuck? Oh, I got a whole damn stash, nigga. No place for you to get it right now.
What you talking about, Willis?
Oh, nigga, I'm gonna tell you straight up, little boy. There's a place for a bunch of crack and cash. Look at that, motherfucker. Oh, that's some good shit. Oh, damn. Yep. And I'm gonna be hood hopping everywhere. Just take me. Let's go, man. I'm high as fuck, man. Shut the fuck up. Let's go, man.
I forgot what Aladdin's about.
Dude.
Yeah.
That it was just my whole fucking childhood was just overdub city. That Aladdin from Compton is 7 minutes long. I used to think I would be watching that in fucking tears, crying.
Yeah, that's the fun. As funny as it gets, yeah.
I learned what an overdub was, and I was like, this is as funny as things can possibly get. It looks like they're saying it.
Yeah.
Y'all want some crack was every recess, every school bus, all that shit.
Yeah, I totally forgot about that movie.
Aladdin?
Yeah, I was sitting there going like, what is happening? He was in jail?
Yes.
Yeah, I don't remember any of this.
My side of the farm wasn't really Disney heavy. The other side of the farm was Disney heavy.
Yeah,
I was just Godzilla, shit like that, skate videos, you name it.
You're like way cooler, is what you're saying.
Nah, I like the Disney movies. I think they're fucking cool. We just didn't get into it. There was one that I was obsessed with. It was Princess and the Goblin or something like that. There was a magical ball of yarn, and there was these goblins under the fucking city that looked hilarious. And it was like a fight between them and the people of the city. It's fucking sick. The very beginning of it, there was a Berry Berry Kicks ad. And I saw that, and we went to Gennardi's the next day. I was like, can we please get Berry Berry Kicks?
It worked.
They're discontinued. That was my favorite cereal. That was as sugary as my mom would let us go, was Berry Berry Kicks.
Wow, that's pretty sad.
Have you ever had them?
I don't think I did, no. I have Kicks, though.
Nah, dude. Yeah. Berry Berry Kicks were so fucking good. I could eat multiple bowls. That's the one thing. Like, we didn't get that shit because, like, in your realm, it was you three. There were six, dude. And they were grown boys. You get a box of cereal, it's deleted in the first day. Everyone grabs at least two, maybe three bowls.
Yeah.
So you just got to get the shitty cereal no one wants.
I guess, man.
Tom went on a kick for a while where he was getting the shit called Good Friends. He was just trying to get the most fiber-heavy cereal to take the biggest dumps, and Good Friends was the nastiest shit I've ever ate in my life.
No, I don't eat that stuff.
It's fucking horrible.
You should just get the bags.
Oh, you used to get
the big-ass bags of generic Frosted Flakes.
Dude, yeah. I remember seeing that. It was never allowed.
Yeah, I know. I know what you grew up in.
Just fucking my mom.
Well, you have all your teeth, so that's true. Something.
My mom hated preservatives. She used to go to this place called Martindale's before like there was Whole Foods and shit, and they had this like soda that wasn't soda. It was just like cranberry and seltzer. It was fucking amazing. I wish they still had it.
Yeah, I'd probably have some version of it.
Some version, but I'm saying, like, if you hit me with that exact can, I know it looked very fucking odd, but boy, did I used to love that shit. Going on missions with my mom was fucking awesome. Anytime you see, going to Gennardi's, all that shit, I used to love fucking doing that.
Oh, yeah, I was with my mom's shadow when I was little.
Car rides were just fucking, I'm not, like, bragging to you, but back then, it was just every car ride, if it was plus 20 minutes, A, felt like eternity, B, I almost shit myself. Every time I got in the car, I would just be like, I'm going to shit my pants. Every fucking time until I finally one day whole dump in my pants facing the wrong way on the front seat. Just like, fuck.
Yeah, it happens, dude.
That final thing where you just let go.
When you let go, yeah.
That just like.
There's a great Louis episode of that.
Really?
Yeah, he's like hanging out with his daughters. And I can like, this is like part of the stuff I couldn't relate to when I was younger, but like now I totally get it. Like he's with his daughter and he's like, we got to go. And they start walking fast. He's walking fast. And then he pulls this maneuver where they, like, get to a spot. And the daughters are making complete sense.
Yeah.
They're like, Dad, just go in here. Because the daughters are like, they'll let you use the bathroom.
Yeah.
And he takes the time out of his, like he's barreling home.
Yeah.
He takes the time to go in and ask. And they say, get the fuck out of here. And then it's over. That feeling, like, that's when you lose it.
That's pure denial.
But that's when it starts to, like, really be an emergency. And then you're not going to make it. You know you're not going to make it, and then you just commit. And he tells his daughters to just go. And he's like, don't look at me, just go.
Have you ever had one that bad?
Yeah.
Like when you're...
Dude, my Uncle Charlie did it. No whip? My Uncle Charlie did it one time. We were in an elevator.
Oh.
And he almost made it, and then he just didn't. Oh, a couple of times, yeah. He was like in his 40s.
I can imagine being out, though, and like stranded, and you have to walk home.
What do you mean?
Like, if you don't, you're whipless, and you're just walking on the sidewalk, and like, I really have to fucking take a shit. You shit yourself outside.
Yeah, and then you made a mess.
What's the protocol, though, after that happens?
It's survival of the fittest, dude, whatever you can get your hands on.
Situation normal, yeah. All fucked up.
Yeah.
That blows.
You're just taking care of it.
Yeah, I've only had two mega logs that have happened in my life, preschool and probably second or third grade, where it was pure shit in my pants.
Yeah, it's not fun.
Anything else is just, I'm chucking.
Just hilarious. It's hilarious when Louis does it, dude.
Yeah, obviously.
He does it like it's so real. And you know he's acting.
Yeah.
But it's so real.
He's obviously shit his pants before. Yeah. what the fuck was I talking about? Oh, yeah. Being able to go to the store and get the shit. Like, commercials worked like a motherfucker when I was younger. But it was.
All that Disney stuff works. That's what people are terrified about.
Yeah, especially with the new ones.
Yeah, like Fed hit me with the new Little Mermaid, and like I guess she's not. Yeah, I guess she's not like white enough. She's like CGI'd.
Bro,
she's not really white. She's like kind of like tannish.
But it's swimming.
Huh?
But it's swimming.
What do you mean?
That's our kind of thing.
Well, anyway.
Just is though.
Yeah, I'm just saying. Like people are very keen into like the Disney stuff because the kids get completely roped into it.
Yeah,
and like any kind of propaganda or like commercialism that they push, the kids want it immediately.
Yeah, the Street Sharks fucked me up when I was younger.
Yeah,
I needed Street Sharks in the worst fucking way. I used to catch that every now and then, and I'd be like, "Please, for the love of God, can I get Street Sharks?"
I think they're losing it though. Like I feel like it's the same thing. Like
there's too much.
There's like an intellectual drought with making movies and making like content for this stuff because. I tried, EJ came over and it was like late at night and I was like, oh, dude, this will be cool. I'll show him Jurassic Park. It might have been the worst movie I've ever seen in my life.
Really?
The new Jurassic Park's trash.
Why?
But it kind of looks like they're just trying to sell little dinosaur toys, but they're really not even that good at it. Yeah. Like the last time I saw
OG Jurassic Park toys, dude, I would fucking kill. So I had a backpack of the T-Rex coming out of the back of the backpack, dude.
That's wild.
Dude. That was sick.
Yeah, like, I never...
The head was coming out of the back of the backpack.
I mean, you're a lucky dude that your mom got
I was obsessed with dinos, bro.
I mean, like, there's a... My one little nephew's so obsessed, he got a like a bearded dragon. He collects, like, amphibians.
Damn.
It's fucking cool shit. Next level. But they have... The last ones that I saw that were good was, obviously, Baby Yoda and BB-8, the Star Wars. They, like, have the best people.
What's BB-8?
BB-8's a little white ball.
Oh, wow, yeah,
the
yeah.
two little white balls.
That's a perfect toy.
And so they're real good toy make. They're, like, real good toys. But the dude that came up with Gremlins in the 80s is suing Baby Yoda.
Are you serious?
They're suing. He's suing Disney because it's pretty much the same head. So he's... There's, like, a whole controversy now where he's saying, like, you guys ganked my shit.
Holy fuck.
Yeah.
Were there Gremlin toys?
Oh, yeah, dude. Gizmo was, like, that was everywhere. Oh, yeah. For years, too. So, like, back in the day when they would make a movie, they would be it would be forever. Like, they made Return of the Jedi, and Ewoks were on the shelves for, like, a decade.
Yeah. And you worked at Toys R Us, too.
Yeah, worked at Toys R Us, yeah. So, fucking video... Then video games started doing it.
Yeah.
You know? But now I feel like the talent is not in the movie.
Toys are retarded, dude. Every time there's a... like a birthday party or something, I'll go to like Walmart, or like my last birthday present was kind of goat, but going to Walmart and trying to get toys, it sucks.
Yeah, like I love movies, can pretty much sit through almost anything. I was watching that Jurassic Park Dominion, and it's like they have a raptor that Chris Pratt trained, okay. And then it has a baby. And I was like, they're just trying to sell the toy. But it's really not even that good of a movie, and it's not even that good of a toy. I mean, maybe everybody's going to want these little raptors, but I think the sun is set on that stuff.
Yeah. They,
like, the merch that they made off of those Star Wars with BB-8 and Baby Yoda, like, that's coining it.
That was crazy. Like, they do some crazy-ass rollout on social media now. They did. There's a lot of truck drivers that have Baby Yoda either in the window or attached to their front bumper.
All the black dudes have Baby Yoda tees.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't know it affected the culture like that.
Oh, yeah, they love it.
Yeah, the toys are ass now, because I remember like being hard to breathe when I was in Toys R Us, because I couldn't like figure out what the fuck I should get.
Oh, dude, I witnessed this.
It was the best.
Yeah, I used to demo toys and ran a Pokemon League, and
you
like
used to demo the toys.
I used to demo toys, and that would be like more money. I was getting like 11, I think. I was getting $8 an hour on the register. And I would get like 11 if I was demoing toys.
They bumped, you fucking serious?
Dude, they bumped me up into the, I think it was called the R Zone. I'm going way back now. Yeah. But
The R Zone.
I was like.
Was that the little like playpen area that was in there?
No, that was like the video game area. It was like sectioned off.
Oh, yeah.
You would try to sell people books to like beat Zelda. And then they would, like, I was so good at it.
Game Boys were also coming out then too, right?
Game Boys were already
Colors,
out.
Though.
It was back when they had like Dreamcast
and
64.
Okay. Yeah.
So I was really good at selling. I was really good at video games because I liked them.
Yeah.
And then
passionate.
They just kind of looked at that like they're numbers guys.
Yeah.
And they were like, you got to start selling. The biggest ticket item at Toys R Us is bikes. So if you're good, they put you back into the bikes. And there
they're
was this,
so expensive.
There was this black dude that was like running the bikes, and he was like the king of the sales at Toys R Us. And I worked my way up from cashier.
You're a ground floor guy.
Ground floor. Seasonal ground floor. Well, what happened was my mom died, and I needed a job.
Yeah.
And Toys R Us was right down the street.
That was close, yeah.
Yeah, so I was like, I'll just go here. I like this stuff. It's fine.
Yeah.
So they put me into the fucking... I started working crazy hours just to avoid all
just
life.
Just saying yes.
Yeah, I was like, I said yes to everything. I worked, like, Christmas, crazy hours. And then they put me in... Dude, the scams they used to try to run.
What do you
on
mean?
On Black Friday and around Christmas with the fake credit cards and shit.
What?
And I was a cashier. I was a lowly... They used to try to run on me.
Yeah.
But anyway, they put me in the fucking video game section. I did good. Then they tried to push me back to bikes. I couldn't sell a fucking bike, dude. And then the guy...
That's a high-ticket item.
The
bro.
Guy that ran the place was like... He was a part-time fireman, and then he ran towards Ross.
Was he at the fireplace next door?
Yeah.
Okay.
So that wasn't there. It was down the street.
Got it.
But anyway, he pulled me aside in the back one time and was like, dude, what's going on? Like, do you want to even work here type shit? Because I couldn't sell bikes. And I was like 19. I was like, dude, whatever.
Do you remember the price?
The price of what?
Bikes?
They were in the ones.
Really?
Most of them were in the ones. And then there would be like twos and fours.
you're probably talking Harrow or Mongoose, honestly.
They didn't have the cool bikes. That was the reason I couldn't get into it.
Oh, they
Toys R Us
had
like fucking Huffies and stuff. So
blow me, bro.
I literally told a dude. I told a kid before. I was like, "You want to get a Mongoose Expert, dude? Get the fuck out of here." But he pulled me in the back in the warehouse, and he was like, "Let me show you something." And he showed me his like paycheck year to date.
Oh come on, man! Dude, how old was he?
Probably like 38, maybe.
Go fuck yourself, dude.
And he was like, you could work here. You could be me one day. This kind of shit, right?
Oh,
and it was 42,000. It was 42,000 a year. And even at 19, I was like, dude, get the fuck out of here with that.
That's dude.
And then I lost every ounce of me being there. I was like, done. But dude, when I first started in like the Halcyon days, when I still had the glow,
yeah,
like, and I would be like, well, they dressed me up like Link.
Hilarious.
Yeah. And then they had me do the Pokemon. When these kids would bet on Sunday mornings, Toys R Us would be closed. And it was open during the day, but it was before they opened up.
Yeah.
We would set up tables. And the cards would be there. Like the kids would bring their cards and like you could buy cards. And they would do, there was like a Pog thing and a Pokemon thing. And at 10 in the morning.
Do you understand how Pogs work?
I didn't understand how any of this shit worked. I was just basically a babysitter.
Yeah.
And these moms would bring these kids in, dude. And it was like fucking nuts. Imagine being able to go to Toys R Us when it's closed.
Yeah.
There's no one there. The whole front of the store is set up for you to have a Pokemon tournament.
Yeah. That's like the feeling I probably got when I was at FDR.
I mean, they were like sprinting, sliding. Like it was mayhem. But
slide was very key when you were young. When we all had to sit in the gym before we went into school, and like our floor was ass. Like it was so slippery. But main thing, you get in if you can. The minute you're in that door, if you can slide your backpack all the way to your class, you're a legend. And then you go as far as a slide as you possibly can in there. So the run to the slide is kind of good, honestly. If I could, I still would.
It was insane. It was insane to watch because it was ages. It was like 8 to 15, which was weird because there was like 14-year-old. I was only like 19.
Yeah.
And there were like 14-year-old dudes in there, like very serious about Pokemon.
So you don't know about porn, bro?
Yeah, I was like, you know there's girls, right?
Jesus Christ.
It was crazy.
Yeah, that shouldn't be legal for those dudes to fucking hit you with that, like, you could be me shit. Because when I was working at Pat's Pizzeria, I was doing the same shit where I was like, dude, I'm just trying to get paid. And it was, like, full weeks of work, $162, $7.25 an hour. And then, like, finally, I fucked up with something. I left without telling them or something. And not even on a, like, I'm fucking out of here, which is, like, my time's finished. I'm 15. I'm leaving now.
Yeah, right.
I don't know where the fucking stupid-ass Greek fuck that owns this place is. So I left, and I came back next day, like, what the fuck was that all about? And the dude who motherfucked me, he died in a motorcycle accident in South America. Neither here
nor... Yo, bro, I'm fucking done with you, man. I'm done with you, dude. Your hexes are too powerful.
Neither here nor there.
We're not even going to get into the amount of people that you've hurt along the way.
Don't hurt me. I won't hurt you.
This is fucking insane, dude.
Keep commenting on the fucking Patreon. If I get your face, dude, it's done. This dude taught himself how to fucking speak English through movies. I thought that shit was sick. But, like, I was working my ass off, and I left that one day. And I came back the next day, goes, dude, we were about to give you a raise, like all this shit. And like, mind you, I'm getting $7.25 an hour answering phones. And like, they're trying to like get me to pop bubbles on the pizza while I'm answering phones. Like, dude, I'm just not built like that. I got a hot chick that's fucking working there that would never touch me. And then I got another kid who's fucking smoking weed and having sex telling me that his dick stuck to his leg from pussy juice.
Jesus Christ.
I had no idea what the fuck that meant.
Yeah, I know.
I was fucking zims. What do you mean, bro?
Dude, when I first found out they get wet, that was fucking insane.
Yeah, and like, dude, they pulled that whole thing. The minute that dude motherfucked me, I was just like, fuck this, dude. Like, you're all lying to me. Like, forever, dude. No one has ever shot me straight in the workplace in my entire fucking life.
Yeah.
It's all fucking lies. That dude could have just been like, hey, man, chill out. Sometimes Sniz comes here. There's a place down the street that cuts hair. Those girls come in. Maybe I can send you down there and you can fucking drop shit off to them, get boners. They didn't want to do any of that. They wanted to stick me behind the fucking counter. I'd smell like French fries fucking constantly. Never get any fucking pussy. Never do any of that shit. Just get mogged by a fucking pussy ass. This dude that ran this place, dude, I fucking hated him. And when it snowed out, he'd wear a neon yellow spider expensive ass fucking snowsuit and just sit in his back fucking room and chill.
Yeah.
I wish I would name him right now, but I don't feel like fucking making it personal against the man.
Dude, I had a series of fucked up jobs, and I had a hard time in between like 19 to like 21 and my buddy got a job. Two of my friends separately, like outside of friend groups, like two separate dudes ended up working for this one dude that owned a limo agency.
What?
And they would drive limos for him to the city, and he would do gay stuff. And
the owner.
And it was bizarre, dude. And he was always being like, yo, you got any friends? Like that kind of thing. And then my buddy fucking took me there, like, this dude will do anything for money. And I was like, the fuck I will, dude. I was like, what are we doing here?
What happened?
We fucking left. I was like, what the fuck was that? He was a bad friend. This guy got me in tons of trouble.
Was he trying to like pimp you, or was he just like, this dude's down to work?
I don't know what his deal was, dude. I was like, not with this guy at all.
You're not with that gay shit, dude.
I wasn't with any of it, dude. I was like, this is fucking shady. Yeah, but two of my friends ended up working for him.
Damn. How are they making out now?
Good.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So maybe
I think one's good. One might have gotten in a lot of trouble.
Yeah.
He was basically a criminal. He had a criminal mind. The one that brought me there had a criminal mind.
Right.
There's people out there you have to understand that have criminal minds. They can't relax. They can't like do normal shit.
Yeah.
They have to like they have to like have an angle on something and then like try to like manipulate the situation where they can win.
Their methadone is stealing from Wawa.
Whatever it is, dude, there's some people that just can't shake it.
Yeah, the one dude that
they go over the line every time.
He's old as shit. And it's like, dude, we go and get before we do a demo job, I'll bring it with me. I'm like, grab a water, grab a sizzly, grab a coffee. He coined the term animalistic. He might have not coined it, but he's the reason I know the term animalistic. I have no idea if it's real or not. He gets sugar and puts it in the palm of his hand and then pours it into the cup. The whole time, we're in like a black neighborhood, or mainly black and Mexican. I'm across Wawa. And he just keeps
Drexel Hill.
Drexel Hill keeps asking me over and over, Billy, aren't you just proud to be white?
Yeah
Marty, technically, yes. I'm like, I'm not fucking pissed about it. Like,
everyone else is proud. What the fuck?
Like, I'm such a proud white man. And the whole time he's doing this, he's just lining his shit with like tasty cakes, all this stuff. We get up to the register, and I'll get him his sizzly. I'll get him a coffee. We walk out, and he just immediately pulls out of his pocket, like, yo, do you want this fucking Enemans? Like, Marty, no, dude. Like, why do you do this? There's no reason for you to be stealing for a while.
Yeah, I would have bought it for you.
And he thinks he's like doing some slick criminal shit. It's like, no one wants to deal with that, dude.
Yeah.
Just stop fucking stealing fucking sweet treats for a while. There's no reason for that.
Yeah. Sometimes the Entenmann bear calls, though.
It's that, and then there's the like cherry soft pies bakes, and stuff. Dude.
Soft baked cookies.
It's rugged, dude. Like, I brought him to a hipster bar, and me and him are just fucking chilling. We're at the bar, and the whole time, like, I'm surrounded by fucking hipsters. This is a little while ago, before they were, like, real into social justice, but you still couldn't, like, really fly, like, pop off. They were more crusters. It was around, like, in Point Breeze where all those crusters were. But, like, we were in there, and you're just like, the guy's like, what do you want to drink? He's like, I want to drink something that, you know, like mud. I want some diesel. And he's like, well, do you want, like, a Miller Lite? He's like, I'm not a faggot. Give me a Guinness. I want to drink mud. I don't want to be able to see the bottom of that cup. And the dude's face was fucking
melting. Yeah.
And the whole time I just have to sit there and just be like, whatever. I mean, this is just
these guys exist, you know?
It is a shock to those guys when like they sit there and like cry about racism and microaggressions. Like, dude, I'll show you the most macroaggression human you'll ever fucking witness, and you'll forget about all that shit.
Oh yeah.
This dude hates that you exist.
No, it's not even that. Like, I don't think you could understand it.
No.
You could try to explain that dude's existence, and like Marty would be like, what? None of it would make sense.
It wouldn't compute to a dude. Like, that's, you can't explain it. It's just right or wrong. And this dude's like a lie detector test. Like, does this make sense? Does this not make sense? And then it gets a little fucked up due to angel dust consumption as a youth. But other than that, like, this dude's spot on. I kind of use him as my barometer on what's making sense and what isn't making sense.
Yeah, definitely.
But he can't. It sucks because there's not that many of the, like, that dude is dying. Like, that breed of human is kind of just falling by the wayside, and everyone just is kind of buttoned up. But having loose cannons like that is the best thing in the world.
You need them.
They were doing roof jobs, and Pierre Robert walked out literally from a roof, screamed at him, hey, Pierre Robert, why don't you play some of the B-sides, you faggot? You need people like that in the world to keep people in line. Pierre Robert probably played fucking B-sides after that.
Well, he probably walked around thinking about it all day.
Definitely.
Yeah.
It just, that's a nice little electrical shock that keeps everyone going.
He's, you know, he's a prominent DJ, homosexual male.
Is he really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He definitely swallowed that all day.
Yeah, I mean, getting yelled at.
He milled on that.
I don't see the problem in that shit existing. Like, that kind of fucking banter, I think it's good.
It's only a problem if you're white.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
But, like, overall, I think the world, like, it was safer in the 70s and 80s than it is currently today. Because dudes like that existed, and it wasn't you're just going around places doing whatever the fuck you want because you know there's no consequences.
Yeah, it's like the everyone has guns theory.
Like, this dude got fucking robbed and shot the guy in the nuts. He was delivering a pizza. They tried to rob him as a pizza man, and he shot the dude in the balls.
After multiple attempts.
After multiple robberies, yeah. He then got armed, as he should. It's his fucking Second Amendment, and he fucking shot the dude in the nuts.
Is what it is.
I think we need more loose cannons like that. If the CIA wants to release angel dust, get people on this shit, and get them really fired the fuck up. But, like, it is weird to watch a whole entire, like, breed of fucking humans just know, like, they're slowly going away. Especially with, like, the internet and stuff like that, just completely just wiping any sort of, like you as an individual just completely going away.
It's no country for old men.
True, dude. That's deep AF.
Yeah.
But you got anything else?
No, I'm good.
Yeah, we're good. A little hour and a half, you know?
Sorry that we didn't get anything cool. Yeah.
Yeah. Now, I think on the Patreon, if anyone wants to listen, I brushed up on my astrophysics, and I'm going to talk about CERN and the atom that goes down the CERN tunnel. Saw a lot of guys were interested in that. I didn't know they were, so I read about it. So I'm going to talk about how that works. You know, the God particle, the Higgs and Bobs. I'm going to get into that and see how that goes. Unless it's the last straw and no one wants to listen to that anymore. And if you're the dude who's listening currently and commented that on the YouTube, you're a fucking pussy. You fucking retard. Imagine commenting, this is my last straw. The guys who fucking talk about shitting themselves didn't know what the Higgs and Bobs thing was, dude. I don't give a fuck. I don't care about physics. I'm fucking creeped out by CERN and the weird fucking things they
do. Well, dude, you can do whatever, you can say whatever you want. Why are they doing these weird nerd ceremonies? It's cool. Dude, do you?
Oh, be careful. That's the last straw.
Do you, but...
Fucking us not understanding the God particle is the last straw,
explain
idiot.
The fucking...
I hope you're autistic and you have an excuse.
Explain the ceremonies.
You can't. That's what I'm saying.
That's all. Yeah. You know?
But it's like, oh, no. These guys have no understanding of fucking physics. Dude, I went to physics for a semester at Temple. I screenshotted...
Dude, I did good at physics.
I screenshotted my fucking...
I just didn't
fucking,
get to particle physics.
Yeah. And like, dude, unless you work for CERN, blow me. You have no idea what's going on. There's like, oh, you know, I went to school for that. I did that. I did it a lot. Like, are you working at CERN? Send me a picture of you in CERN in front of the fucking collider. Then I'll shut the fuck up. If you don't, I don't care. I'm obsessed with a ton of shit, dude. But I don't know about it. You probably don't either. You probably read a bunch of books. Congratulations. Books usually turn out to be fucking fake. So you probably just read a bunch of fake shit that was paid for by some fucking weird company.
All right, you good?
I just like when you start hitting with this is the last straw that we didn't understand fucking physics, dude. Literally kill yourself with the gay shit. It's like, oh my god, dude, this is brutal. Is it brutal, dude? Then go listen to The Portal with Eric Weinstein, you fucking homo. Listen to his fucking theory of everything. That'll be fucking sick. Listen to him roll off the tongue bullshit. The dude said he figured out fucking air. That's you. You figured out everything, and now you're in the YouTube comment section. You fucking mongoloid. It's so infuriating, dude. Listen to the Dark Horse podcast. Listen to the fucking Portal. Do whatever you want. Just don't listen to us. Don't subscribe to our Patreon. Don't do any of that stuff, because you just pissed me the fuck off, and you ruined my week. And I sit here, and get to hang out with my friend, and I see negative Nancys in the comment sections freaking out because we don't understand fucking particle physics. You don't understand particle physics. Send me a picture of your degree in particle physics, and I'll shut the fuck up. Send me the degree from fucking Harvard and your pay stub from CERN, and I'll shut the fuck up about any particle physics talk for the rest of my fucking life. And if you're just obsessed with it and you really love it, Fuck off, dude. Listen to The Portal with Eric Weinstein's fucking faggot ass. I digress, dude. I sometimes get fucking angry, especially at negative comments, because honestly, they fucking affect me in a negative way. I try to just enjoy fucking life. I'm going to the mountains this weekend for a fucking birthday party. Maybe I'll get some pussy and cool the fuck out. But not when you fucking put some gay shit.
That happens when you're on shriv.
That happens when you're on fucking 2 week shriv, dude. Oh, my head's about to pop. My particles are gonna fucking pop, dude. CERN. I don't understand it. It's like, it's fucking mind blowing to me.
I can't wait to learn all about it.
Yeah. Maybe he can fucking zoom us. Tell us all about how they figured it out. How they figured out the most elusive particle in the world. You got it because you read the fucking thing. You read all the stuff. You got it. You figured it out. Dude, we're in a ball in space. No one can explain what's up there. You think you got this figured out, dude? I got a fucking horse to sell you.